I'm excited. Okay, so I have Coke here. I have a little bowl of rice. I only have one crab. I'm gonna try our potato. By the way, I like this little potato because they are like creamy for me than the regular big potatoes, so I choose this. Very good. To be honest, it's actually my first time doing this recipe. This seemed to come out pretty good. They're spicy, actually. Bowl for that. It is spicy, but it's good. If you are curious on how to make your own Cajun spices, I will totally make this again. The spices is only good for the people who can handle spicy. This is actually pretty spicy. Seafood is like my favorite food. That's why this week I've been thinking to do this. It's pretty good. Yeah. So in crawfish is what I've seen them do it. They actually like, yeah, just pull the this. They're kind of hard. Harder than shrimp, actually. I haven't actually had crawfish much. I think this is my second time. They're not bad. So the difference between crawfish and the shrimp in eating side of it, the shrimp is, for me, is a lot more easier to peel and have more meat. And the taste, they're a little bit similar for me. So I can go either way. But definitely, if you want more meat and easier, you have to go with the shrimp. The combination of the Cajun spices is actually pretty good. I made my own combination for it. Thank you. I heard the lemon juice, salt and pepper. Let me try it. Not bad. I can go without sauce. Not bad at all. Mm-hmm. Let me set aside the head over there. I might go through them later. See what I mean? This thing is a lot more harder for me. Oh, finally. See? That's the meat of a crawfish. It's a little bit smaller than the shrimp. Let me try the crab. So I have some few crab claw. By the way, I have blue crab today. my crab meat. There's some meat that you can't quite get. Use the other claw to dig them. It's pretty good. I wouldn't thought lemon, salt and pepper taste good. It's actually pretty good as a sauce. just wonder where I went for my vacation. I actually went to Philippines, of course, with my family here. Okay, let's check our crab. It's fat. Ooh, and it is. Okay. So the one thing I've learned in Philippines when I went there, when my nephew taught me, he said if you buy crab in the market, to differentiate if it's skinny or fat, because obviously for me I like fat because there's more meat in it. You have to pay attention. You have to do this in the back. Yeah, tap them in the back like that. And if it sound hollow, that means it's skinny. So you have to find the one that doesn't sound like hollow. And I tried it yesterday and it worked. See the yellow things? Those yellow things present that this thing is fat. I don't know, it's like, I don't know what it is, like an egg or, I don't know. And you can eat them. If you want. I'm actually happy that worked. Because that one's my first time trying it. Because every time I buy a crab, I don't really know how to differentiate the skinny and the fat. Now I know. So that's the one good thing I got from Philippines this time. Yeah, it's pretty fat. Like it. So get the gills out. Teeth. I think that's a teeth. And then you break it in half. Oops. This didn't come up. Oh my god. See how fat that is? Now you know how to find the right crab for you. Crab is expensive when you buy them. Most of the time, if you don't know, they're skinny. And you spend a lot of money for them. I'm getting full. I don't know if I can finish it, but this thing is spooky. Poke the meat out. I see. A lot ahead. My last crawfish. their heads. So big. Okay, the smell of shrimp. I finished them, except for one potato. These are all heads, so I'm basically done with this crawfish. So thank you very, very much for watching. If you have any question, just leave me a comment below and I will get back to you. Thank you and I will see you next time. Bye.